In this video, we're going to test three Bolt alternatives, and by the end, you're going to see if any of them stack up to Bolt. So Bolt is an AI app builder, and these alternatives are similar and provide similar functionality. The first one we're going to test is Lovable. And what I'm going to do for each of these AI app builders is do a quick demo asking each one to build us a simple to-do app. The reason I'm doing that is it's a simple example that is going to give us something to compare between all of them. So let's say a simple to-do task app. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit submit. And what Lovable does is they basically do all of the work in the background for you to set up your app and get it connected in the beginning. So what they do here on the left side is first they give a few things that it's going to use to get started with. So design inspiration, features that it's going to include, and design elements. And here we go. It's built us a simple task app. And I like how it made it really minimal with the design, because that's kind of what I asked for, just a very simple app. So let's say the task is go to the gym. It kind of has this nice little design. If I check it off, it looks like it's just going to get cleared out, or it just gets crossed off, and then I can press X to remove it. So task one, task two, task three. Can I drag them? I cannot, so I can't change the order. But just a really simple, minimal task app that it made really quickly. Let's ask it to do one thing just so we can compare kind of a follow-up question for each of them. I'm going to say, please add due dates. And let's see how it does with that. I'll go ahead and pause the video and let it build that out. So it should have added a due date. Let's see, task one, if I click due date. Task one. It looks like it's a little bit of a not perfect design, so I'd have to go over and click that plus. Oh, the due date's there, and then that's the plus button. So task one, let's see if I can get it. There we go. So the design's not amazing. I'm just going to say, could you separate the date picker and the add task button so they are completely separate? Okay, let's see if that solves it real quick. Just kind of do a quick edit here. All right, cool. So not perfect design, but let's try it again. Task three, now we can set a due date and add it. Okay, cool. So that's Lovable. Obviously, we could go into a lot more detail. I have other videos on Lovable, so check out the No Code MBA YouTube channel for our full Lovable guide, where we go into a lot more detail. Lovable is a really powerful tool. I think that it is just as capable as Bolt, and both tools are improving really quickly, but Lovable is a really great option. So now let's go on to the next tool. The tool I'm going to test now is Hey Boss. The URL is heyboss.xyz. This is a newer tool, and I want to check it out here with you live and see how it compares to Bolt. So what I'm going to do is do the same prompt that I did before. I want to create a simple task app, simple to-do list task app. So let's click Generate. And the way that Hey Boss works is here on the left side, kind of similar. It says it's thinking, please wait 2 to 3 minutes, and it's going to ping us with a sound when it's ready. So in my testing before, I found Hey Boss to take a little bit longer to generate than a Bolt or Lovable. But I'll go ahead and pause the video, and I'll let you know how long it takes once it's completed. So here we are, it finished. It actually didn't take much longer than Lovable or Bolt, I will say. I think it did a good job here. And it similarly to Lovable kind of writes out its thought process of the features and the design that it's going to do, creates a plan, and then it generates it. So let's test it out. Let's say task one, task two, and very similar design to Lovable so far. Something that's kind of cool about Hey Boss is it looks like I can just click any of those basically designs. Once I clicked that, it basically immediately went over and opened up this AI chat again, and it looks like it's essentially going to rewrite the code based on what I clicked. So it's kind of makes it, I kind of have some presets that makes it easier to change the design, which I think is helpful for people who might not be technical at all and just want to click a button and be able to have something change. So I like that. So something else that you can do with Hey Boss is you can click on the top and click this arrow, double click, and it looks like you can target specific parts of the app really easily. This is something that I believe Lovable is building in soon as well. But pretty cool. And then also, if you click that pencil button, you can go in and actually edit the text directly, which I think is also really cool. So you don't have to prompt it to change the text. You just go ahead and click that pencil button, and then you can change the text on anywhere on the app. So add task. Looks like I can't put a space there, but still pretty cool that I can just edit it directly. Okay, cool. So now it looks like what it's doing is it changed the design based on the theme here that we created. So let's do task one. Okay, cool. So that's all working really well. The next thing I want to do is add the same feature that we did before. So let's say please add due date functionality. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll pause the video and I'll come back once it's finished. Okay, so here we are. Now it added the due date. So we'll say task one, we can add a due date here, hit submit, and there we go. So it added it really well. I think it actually added it better than Lovable. So so far, I'm really impressed with Hey Boss. There's definitely more that we need to test to see if it's able to do all the same functionality of Bolt and Lovable and kind of how it is able to do as we add more complexity. But I am really impressed with that. It looks like you can also publish it to a URL that's very similar to Bolt and Lovable. Okay, cool. So let's move on to our last tool in this experiment. So the final test we're going to do is using Replit Agent. So here we are in Replit, and I'm going to say the same prompt that I did before. I want to build a simple to-do app. Okay, so let's go ahead and click start building. And it's going to go ahead. Similarly, it's going to have this kind of onboarding where it's going to ask, kind of create a project plan and ask if I want to go ahead with it. So let's let it do that. So here it is. It says it's going to build the initial prototype. It's asking if we want to add due dates for tasks. I'm going to do that later. So let's just start with the basic prototype. And then just like the other tests, we will add that later. Now remember, these are all really simple kind of builds that we're asking it to do, just a to-do list app. We could do a future comparison where we ask it to do something more complicated. The video would be a bit longer then because I wanted to just make it a simple comparison. But just know that kind of this is the minimum bar that every one of these apps should be able to do a good job at. And then as you get more complicated, that's where it starts to get a little bit tricky. So here we are with our first prototype. We can go ahead and add tasks. Oops. So when I tried to add the task, there is an error. So first off the bat, there was an error here while the other apps did not have that. So I'm going to say there was an error, and I'll copy when I tried to add a task. So I'm going to give it that. I'll pause the video and come back once it's finished. So it says it fixed it. Let's try task one. Now it seems to be working. If I check them off, it should go into completed, which it does. And then under active, these are the ones that are not checked off. So it did a pretty good job with that. Let's go ahead and say, now it works. Can you add due dates? And it is loading now. So I'll pause the video and come back once it's finished. So here we are. It now has a date option. So I'm going to say, go to the gym. Let's add a date and click add. Okay, cool. So it does have, it's a little bit off because task two, okay, let's see if I put it on February 11th, click add. Now it says due February 10th. So the timing may be a little bit off. It's probably doing that like February 10th at 11:59 p.m. maybe. So a little bit off there. We could definitely tweak that. I think we can make it work correctly. But overall, also pretty good. Replit Agent, I've found, and I think I've seen it here too, is just a little bit more buggy sometimes. I'm sure it's going to keep improving, but that's just what I've seen so far. So hopefully you found these three comparisons helpful. We went over Lovable, Hey Boss, and Replit. I definitely recommend checking all of these out yourself, testing your own app ideas with it, and seeing which one performs the best for you. These tools are always improving, so it's worth checking them out and seeing how it works for your use cases. Leave a comment if you have any questions below, if there's anything you want us to test in the future. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this for free. And this video is brought to you by No Code MBA, an online education platform teaching you how to build with AI and no code tools from start to finish. Check the link in the description to learn more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.